Hey guys, it's Nini. Welcome back. Thanks for clicking on this video. I am actually getting close to running out the door. I'm gonna go meet a friend of Janie right here.
Well, you don't wanna be on camera.
She's not feeling it today, you guys. So I'm actually gonna go be meeting a couple of friends right now. I'm gonna go do one of my friends' makeup and we're gonna go watch the movie Hustler. But I wanted to jump on here and film a haul really quick because if I don't do it today, like, I don't think I'm gonna get around to it. And I don't really want to wait until next weekend because next weekend I want to do makeup looks. I actually want to film this look right here, but I don't know. I'm getting really excited. It's the day before fall. It's the 22nd today. She's playing with her toy. It's the 22nd today and tomorrow's the first day of fall, so I'm really excited about that. If you guys want me to film this makeup look, let me know in the comments down below. But let's get started into my little mini haul. Me and my friend Audrey, me and my friend went to a few stores yesterday just to go see if there's any new clothes or anything like that, and we did find some very nice things. So the first store we went to was Walmart, which I love, freaking love Walmart, you guys. So I don't know if you watched my last haul where I was kind of showing you some fall decor that I had gotten for the house, and I had mentioned something about an acorn pillow. Well guys, like almost 2 weeks later, I went back and almost all the pillows are gone. Like there was leaves and things like that. And two acorns left and I got the acorn. So isn't this so cute, you guys? Like, oh, it's so soft and it's pretty small. I mean, it looks big on camera, I guess, but I think it's almost the same size as my head. It's actually quite tiny, a cute little accent, but I thought this was so cute. It's gonna complement my other like blessed pillow that has like pumpkins on it. It's kind of like a burlap kind of material, and I just thought this was so cute. I really wanted to get one of the red or orange leaves, but they didn't have any more. They just had green, and I don't know, isn't it? Like, I think our sofas are already kind of like a dark deep green, so I didn't want to add green pillows to that. I wanted red and orange. Unfortunately, it wasn't there, so I just got the acorn. So that was the first thing. I was really excited about it. The next thing I got was Cotton Rounds. I use these for my toner, my face care routine. I also got some makeup. So, okay, you guys, I told you I was a one mascara person. The mascara I'm currently using and I actually really, really like is the NYX Doll Eye Mascara in the waterproof formula. I love this. But I also run late all the time, so sometimes I have to do my mascara in the car on the way to work. She's being really nosy in all my stuff right now, playing with her little lammy chop. So sometimes I have to do it on my way to work, and I forget sometimes to grab my mascara, my one single mascara. So what I decided to do is buy a second mascara for my makeup bag. In my makeup bag, I have oil blotting sheets, a compact, some lip balm, and a few lip gloss lipstick options on the go. But I decided to throw in a mascara because, you guys, I hate not wearing mascara. Sometimes, I want to do a video where it's like my quick go-to everyday like work makeup routine. It's really fast, super simple, but mascara is definitely a key thing. And the days I forget, guys, the makeup snob in me is devastated. Like, it is really first world problems, but to not have mascara kills me. Like, I need it to like frame my eyes and just like, you know, like wake me up, and I feel like it makes my eyes bigger. So I grabbed this one from my purse. It's the Wet n Wild Mega Length Waterproof Mascara, and I always get waterproof because, like I said earlier, I do have oily skin. So if it's not waterproof waterproof mascara, my natural oils will like act as a makeup remover, and it's all over my face like midday. So I've never tried this before, so I'm excited to try it. So I got that from my makeup bag. I also picked up, I was watching, I can't remember her name, but she like inspired me to get this palette. I'm supposed to be on a minimal no buy, but it kind of broke when I saw her. I'll link her video down below because it was just so cute how she pulled this look together. It's the Profusion Mirage palette, 35 shade palette. Sorry, the light's reflecting. You kind of see like outside. I'm using natural lighting right now, but it has a lot of cute fall natural warm colors, some pinks in there, and some pressed glitters, which is really fun. I didn't really get into, there's this one brand, I can't remember, they had press glitters and I got it for a few of my friends and they loved it, but I never bought it for myself. I actually didn't play with one till recently, which was the one in the Jeffree Star Morphe palette. He has like a really cute pressed gold glitter in there that is actually kind of a pain in the butt to remove. Like, it was just stuck and it was a nightmare. I didn't put it on my eyes, I just swatched it on my hand and it was just, it was crazy. I can't even. But I kind of want to play with it on my eyes when I have time, when I'm not really going to go anywhere, just to see how much I like it. I do love the Stila glitter and glows. I love to tap those all over my eye for a really cute sparkly moment. But pressed glitters is kind of a new thing for me. Let's see, let me open it. Oh, it's still sealed. I'm always bummed when the palette doesn't have the eyeshadow names already on them. But it comes, so like I'm forced to keep like this thing right here. Okay, so this little plastic thing is like glued on the sides. That's weird. Okay, so, oh, kind of sticks back on there too. I don't know. Okay, so I removed the film and this is what the eyeshadows look like. And you see there's a pressed glitter right there, and then this pink one, and this bronze one, this yellow gold one right here. I love it. There's this duochrome shadow, two of them right there, and then one right there that I can't wait to play with. So I'm really excited about this. I think I'm going to try to use this palette, and then I broke down and bought another palette. One that I've been wanting for a long time, actually, so I don't regret it. And I don't regret this one either. This one was really cheap. This was like $10. I forgot how much my mascara was, but this palette for sure, $10. Still with Walmart. Okay, so after the makeup stuff, I did find a few clothing items. I am currently shopping for fall things. So my friend actually spotted this cardigan. And I love cardigans. I wear them year-round here, which is kind of crazy because it does get really hot, but I do work in healthcare and we keep it super cold, always freezing. If anybody works in healthcare, like hospitals and stuff like that, like I think you know what I'm talking about, freezing. So I'm always wearing cardigans year-round. But my friend found this one, this leopard print cardigan, and I love leopard print, you guys. And sorry, I keep playing with my hair. I think I'm just gonna tuck it behind my ear right there. Yeah, okay. So she found this, she spotted this, and we have been kind of into like getting like the same things. And I think it's so cute. Like that's true friendship, you guys, if you wear the same things. Just kidding. No, but I like that that's kind of like our thing right now and that we even have like a thing. I love that. So we couldn't find one for her, but we were able to find it online. So I don't know if she plans on getting it online, but it's so comfortable, so thin. I'm excited to wear this for that. So I think that was $13. So, pretty affordable in my opinion. So last weekend she went shopping and she found a skirt. And so we both have the same skirt and we're actually going to wear matching outfits tomorrow for work. She found this skater skirt, kind of. Let me stand up and show it to you guys. It has buttons going down the front with these little faux pockets right here. They're not real. It's just really cute. So we wanted to wear this to like celebrate the first day of fall. So we're going to be wearing this skirt. And we wanted to find a top. So I found this one. And we both really liked it. It has like a rust color black and kind of like a slate gray and white stripes. I don't know if you can see the gray in it right there. It's a deep gray. So yeah, we're going to pair it. Maybe I'll do like a quick OOTD little outfit of the day snap if I have time tomorrow. If not, maybe I kind of want to do a lookbook, but I don't know. How do you guys feel about this? Not sure. Although it seems really fun. Like I think I'm gonna, it doesn't hurt to try, right? Maybe I'll try doing one. for fall. But yeah, so we got that. We're gonna pair it with the skirt. So I was going to wear that skirt with that long sleeve and these little chunky heel Mary Janes. I have like a little strap right there. I got these from Amazon. They're a brand called City Classified Comfort. And it has like a little small, I don't know if you could see it, little small chunky heel right there. Not that tall, I think maybe 3 inches at the most. So that skirt, I don't know, maybe about all together. See, like it doesn't clash, it's cute. She found one that has like some shoes at Target, because we also went to Target, that has like these sides cut out and it's more of a pointed toe, but it has the chunky heel as well. So we'll be having a little matching twinsy moment. So that's what I got on Walmart. Afterwards, we went to... Oh, no. I lied. So for Halloween, I got these little spooky pencils, and I think I'm going to pass them out October 1st rather than Halloween Day. But they're just little, like, jack-o'-lanterns and kitties. Let's see. Witches, vampires, spiders. And so I'm going to pass these out at random, like, for an employer or whatever. On October 31st. So I got those. They were $1 each or 98 cents each. So I got that. So after that, we went to Target and I didn't find anything at Target. Audrey found some clothes. I think she found some stuff. I can't remember what she found. Did she find tops? I don't know. I can't remember. But so aside from the pencils, when I went to Target in their little dollar section, I found these cute spooky erasers. So there's like jack-o'-lanterns and little ghosties and black cats and spiders and spiderwebs. So I'm just gonna go ahead and pass out like one to whatever employee I see and like look cute and put it all this stuff in a cute little goodie bag and then just go around passing it October 1st. So after Target, sorry if I'm talking really fast, I'm just like trying to get this out of the way so I can pack up my makeup stuff and go to my friend Audrey's house and do her makeup for the movie later. It's gonna be a cute little girls' night. The movie's at 5, but I want to take the time to like do her makeup and explain to her what I'm doing and stuff. So after that, we went to the mall. Went to Walmart, Target, and then we drove to Ulta. Yeah, so we went to Ulta and she went to go get like color matched and stuff like that, so she was able to find a foundation and a concealer and all this other fun stuff, a bronzer, and she was looking at lippies, but I don't think she got a lippy. But I ended up picking up this I'm almost out of setting spray. I really like I love how affordable this brand is, Mario Badescu, and it says it's for all skin types, and I think it sets my makeup down really well.
I tried Urban Decay All Nighter, Urban Decay, Deflake, I have Urban Decay Deflake, I'm almost out of that one. I've tried Model in a Bottle, Morphe Setting Spray, The Continuous Mist, MAC Prep and Prime, I tried NYX, Wet n Wild, what else? I've tried the Too Faced, I can't remember what it's called, but the Too Faced one.
I've tried quite a few. Back to the main point, I went to Ulta and I saw this, and I think if I'm not mistaken, the 4 ounce ones are $7 each. So for 3 4-ounce bottles, I got it for $21, so I saved like $7 because original, right? No, 3 times 7 is 21. Never mind. Never mind, I didn't save anything, but I thought I did. Where is it? I don't know, I guess not. But I got these Mario Badescu ones and I think it's a good price. I've had this for a while and it's lasted me, like, you guys, it has really lasted me. I feel like the Urban Decay ones I go through, the Morphe ones, there's just, because it's a continuous setting mist, I don't know when enough is enough, so I go through those so quickly, like so quickly. Ugh, it's annoying. And it's kind of, I don't know, I can't remember, how much is it, like $15? $15 and it lasts me like what, 2 weeks or something, because I just like I have no self-control. So I like a spritz because and then I feel like I'm just like, okay, I've like enough, pumped it enough, is that the correct term, pumped it, I don't know. So anyways, this one comes with the rose water, it comes with the cucumber and green tea and the chamomile and lavender. I do love the smell of rose, so I think if I were to ever get the bigger size eventually, because that was the plan, was once I was done with this, I was going to get the bigger sizes, but I was also curious about the other 2 cents, so I picked this up. when I finish these, I think I'll just stick to the rose water because I do enjoy that scent. Now, this item that I'm about to show you, I have been wanting this since they announced it, and it hasn't been out that long. It came out this year, I'm pretty sure it came out this year. Oh, you know what? I am missing a store. Okay, I will leave you guys in suspense about what this product is. We went to this weird store called The Boss is Crazy, or The Boss Has Lost It. This store sells things like almost everything is maybe $5 and less, $7 and less. These two skirts I got came out to like $8 combined. So the brown skirt that my friend got me when we went, I also found it in blue. And I love this. This is cute. This is going to be really cute with like a black and white striped long sleeve, maybe with some black tights and my black Oxfords, Mary Janes. It's going to go so many. And then I found this skirt for, it's more of a springtime skirt, so I'm excited to wear it. But it has like this little flare out right here. And it hugs me pretty tight. It's kind of form fitting, so I would like to lose some inches before it's time to start wearing this. I could probably get away with it during the winter too with some black tights and stuff like that and a red long sleeve or something, but I think it's more of a springtime skirt, so I can't wait to wear that for spring, and hopefully by then I can fit into it a little bit better. Back to Ulta and the last product that I have to show you guys. Like I said, I've been eyeing this item for a while, so I was really excited when I saw it, because last time I was at Ulta it was out of stock and I was like, oh bummer, it wasn't meant to be. But I went this time, it was in stock, and it was like totally meant to be. So, where is it? Oh, it's right here. Okay. You guys, I love Morphe. I'm sorry, I know some people have a thing about it. I know some people don't like when, I mean, I'm not saying I'm an influencer or anything, but I know there's like some like new taboo on like Morphe products, like, oh, if you're Morphe, it's like probably a biased opinion. But you guys, I do honestly love Morphe. I love their brushes, I love their palettes, I love the affordability. I love it. I love it. So when I saw this on Instagram, I just about freaked out. It's just so girly and feminine and dreamy and romantic, and like that's the energy I get from looking at this palette, and I love it. Like, it's total Taylor Swift like Lover album cover vibes, and that is the 39S Such a Gem palette by Morphe. So this is the box that it came in. It says, meet your bejeweled bestie. Use the matte shimmer metallic and glitter finishes to luxe up your face and eye looks. Then swipe on the supersized gel-like shades for a flashy highlight or next level eye topper. And of course there's 39, and this is set up like the Dare to Create and the James Charles Artistry palette with the huge pans in the center. So I'm gonna go ahead and just remove like the little plastic thing with the labels, the names of the shadows, and show you guys. I know most of you guys have seen this before, but look at that. Oh my gosh, like I look at it and I just, it's just so girly, you guys. This is my jam. Like, I love pinks and purples. I mean, okay, so I can go up and down the spectrum of eyeshadow color stories. I can do, like, cool tones. I can do warm tones. I can do bright, bright colors. I can, like, I'm not afraid of color. I love to do, like, bright colored looks. Juvia's Place palettes have some bright colors. Jeffree Star has done bright colors. Morphe, BH Cosmetics. Like, I love playing with color. I think it's fun. It makes me happy. So this is kind of like in between. Like, I have some bright colors and then I have some neutrals and warm tones right there. And I do have some cool tones over here. This is just gorgeous. And then I guess this is like a pressed glitter. So it's meant to be. So I'm really excited to play with this. I am going to use a Profusion palette and maybe dip into this palette this week. I'm not too sure about this one. Profusion, definitely, just because that girl, I'm going to link her. I feel so bad because I should know her name. Like, I subscribed to her almost like halfway through her video. I was like, you know what, subscribed. I love her. I loved her vibe, I loved her attitude, I loved her character, I loved how she just walked through like her little get ready with me tutorial thing. It was so cute. But yeah, so we'll see if I use this week. Maybe I'll try next week or during next weekend, but it's beautiful and I couldn't resist. Alright guys, that's it. That concludes my haul for today. I'm gonna go ahead, pack some makeup stuff and some of my tools and such, and head over to my friend's right now to do her makeup. So I'll catch you guys on the next one. Oh, and if you do like this makeup look, let me know if you guys would like to see a video on it. I wouldn't mind recreating it. Maybe I can do it again with the let's get ready kind of thing. I dipped into two different Morphe palettes for my eyeshadow look. My lash line is Stila Shimmer and Glow in Vivid Jade. And my lips is Anastasia Liquid Lip in Trust Issues, if you guys were curious. Alright guys, see you in the next one. Bye. So last weekend she had gone shopping, and you know, this tuck moment isn't cute. Maybe I should quit it. No, whatever. Well, and I don't even know if these videos are ever going to see the light of YouTube. I don't know. For now, they're just kind of sitting in my gallery. Feeling kind of weird because I don't have a pumpkin spice latte right now at this very moment. I did have one yesterday though, so.